Welcome children. Have you all done the first part? Yes or no? Completed, no? You people are confident with the lines, line segments, rays, all these things. Can you tell which one is called parallel line? Can you distinguish the difference between an intersecting lines and concurrent lines? Yes? Okay, if you are confident, then come to the next part. Here we will discuss about the curves. What do you mean by that? Yes, now we are not working with a single lines. Here we will talk about the curves. Curves means what? If you are drawing something without lifting your pen or pencil. Okay, let it be if I am drawing something like that. Yes, that line. Yes. And from here I have started and here only I have stopped. So this one I can say it is a curve. Okay. When that curve what I am drawing, if they are not intersecting each other. Let it be, I am making one, yes, it has not intersect anywhere. So, this one is called simple curve. Yes, I can go for a shape like that. Here also you can see, does it intersect anywhere? Any one line has intersected other line? No, no. So, these kind of shapes, these kind of curves, these are called simple curve. Okay. Then what we will tell in this case? Here also I have not lift out my pen and I have drawn one shape. Is it a simple curve? Yes? No, it's not a simple curve. Why not? Because you can see that I have started from here, then I have extended this one like that. Okay? But that final line here it has intersected that second line. If this was the first one, this is the second line, this is the third line, this is the fourth line. So in this case you have seen that line 2 and 4 has intersect each other. So it's not a simple curve. So which one will be simple curve? This one. Yes, so many lines I have used here. But none of them had intersect each other. So this is a simple curve. Okay, and one more thing. Here also you have noticed, I have started from here. This is the beginning point I have. And this is also the ending point. When that beginning point and ending point join together. Yes? That means we are completing that drawing. And this one will be called as a closed curve. Yes? What we can say this one? This is a closed curve. Okay. Now, I think people have got the idea of this curve. If I have drawn it like that. Yes. I have kept it open. That in starting point and ending point had not touch each other. So this will be called as open curve. And when these two has touched, that starting point and the ending point, it will be called as closed curve. It is clear, no? So, if you have got the idea about this one, for the curves. Curves means any figure. It can be drawn by the straight line. It can be drawn by the straight line. It can be drawn by the curved lines. Now, if I am drawing one figure like that, which will be mixed up with straight line and curved line. Here I have used one curve, one half cyclic, one that curved line I have used here. Can you see it is a polygon? No. Why not? Let me come to that. Polygon, what is the meaning of this term? Polygon means actually the closed figure, which is bounded by the straight line. But in this figure, what I have done, I have taken one curved line. It was not straight line. But if I have drawn one figure like that, let it be here, all the lines, you can see all are straight lines. So this will be called a polygon. So polygon means always it will be a closed figure bounded by straight line. Poly means many. Gon means side. Many sided. But that many sides, all the sides must be straight line. So when I have drawn one polygon, let it be, I am taking one example for a polygon. If it is here, if I am taking it like this is one polygon I have drawn here, and this one, this is a polygon I have drawn here. So that in this polygon, all these lines, these are the lines I have taken here, four lines. These lines are called the sides. These are the sides. And the place enclosed by these sides, this is called the interior. What you will tell this one? Interior. Okay, and that area outside the boundary, these are the sides, these are the boundary, out of them, that is called what? It is, that is the exterior. Yes, it is not being enclosed by any of the lines, but that area enclosed by the lines, this is called the interior. So let's come to some of the shapes. So let me, whatever I have drawn here, let's name this one. I am giving it the name of A, B, C, D. Here you might have noticed that I have used four letters. These four letters A, B, C and D, individually these letters will denote the vertices. Vertices means that point where two lines have met. So here that vertices we have, the name of these will be all the vertices here. What are the vertices we have? We have A, B, then C and D. All four vertices I have. This is A. Yes. Then, first you take that sides now. So, what are the sides we have? Let's come to that. Here, how many sides we have? First one is AB. So, let's name the sides. What are the sides we have? First one is AB. Yes, this is a fixed line. So, I will put that line segment shine over there. Next, from after AB, I can take BC. Yes. Then third one, I can take CD. Yes. And another one is definitely, that is BB. Yes. For a quadrilateral, I have got these many sides, these many vertices. How many angles is there? Yes. How many angles are there? You can say it is angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. So four angles also I have. Yes, I can write how many angles are there. Angle A, angle B, then angle C and angle D. We will learn about the angles afterwards. In the next part we will discuss about this one. Now, whatever vertices I have taken, if I am joining these vertices, what I will got? Yes, that adjacent vertices, if I am joining, this will become the side. Here let it be D and C. If I am joining, this is the side I am getting. But if I am joining the opposite vertices, yes, so opposite vertices of D will be opposite vertex of D, that is we are getting here B. If I am joining these opposite vertices, the line I will get in case of a polygon, that is called diagonal. So here whatever I have drawn, I have got two diagonal. Yes. What are the name of this diagonal in this case? Yes, what are the diagonals I have here? First one is I have AC. We join two opposite vertices A and C. And another one I have in this case, that is equal to BD. We join vertex B and D in a shortest distance by this line segment. Only this much has been you have to do for today's work. In next part we will discuss about the angles. So let's go for the exercise has been given in your book. Okay, and when we are talking about that interior and exterior, yes, you might be clear about this one. That interior part here, that one, that reason, that whole one. Yes, you know that interior is also called the reason. Yes, when we are talking about, or when we are going to solve any of the questions in the later classes, yes, you have to work with this. So you should be clear about this term, this area, that interior part, that is also called the reason of this polygon. Here I have taken the example of a quadrilateral, that means it is a four-sided figure. You can go for you cannot construct any figure with two sides. Yes, you know. So the first one you will get, that is a triangle. Yes, and it is the polygon with least number of sides, that is number three. Three sides will be there. Okay, we will come to this one in next part. So try to solve the questions of the given exercise.